famous grilled lamb chops with very flavorful mint chimichurri sauce. Please welcome back to our home personal chef and cater to the stars, Marcel Cosi.
Yes, thank you. Thank you for having me.
Peter heard you were making chimichurri, and he insisted he stayed.
He's like, I'm in.
He's staying. Yeah. Yep. Love it.
And yep. then country star Craig Morgan heard, and Craig. He said, well, you know what, I'm here anyway. We're going to be speaking with you in just a little bit about Morgan Family Strong, but first we thought we'd feed you. Yeah. And our family is already digging in.
Dig in, folks, please.
All right, so Chef, I know you were born in Brazil.
Yes.
And chimichurri was born in Argentina.
You know your
but
stuff.
I cook a lot
you
as
cook,
well.
I know that it's
really big in Brazil, too.
Yeah, I mean, growing up as a kid, my dad used to grill different meats, and their spin on it is they put chopped tomatoes and peppers. They call it vinagrete.
Yeah.
Can you say that?
Vinagrete.
That's basically vinaigrette. That's what it is. So it's a sauce. But like you said, originally it's in Argentina. It's just fresh herbs. My spin on this one is the mint, because obviously mint and lamb go hand in hand.
Right.
You know, and this is something that my clients rave about. My little baby girl, she's addicted to this stuff.
Oh,
she can't get enough of this stuff. My wife.
Look how old is she?
She's 18 months.
She's adorable, believe it or not.
She's got a palate.
Rose, right?
She's very picky. You know.
She's beautiful.
Wait till Parker has some of this, huh?
Right.
Well, I know your dad taught you how to make this.
Yes.
But you've kicked it up a notch.
You've
become kind of famous for your chimichurri.
You know you've been doing your research.
Yeah.
Yes, I have.
You've won some competitions.
One
or two.
Yes, and I had Gail Simmons, which...
We love.
Gail Simmons is the best, and she gave me the best compliment that just touched my heart.
So what'd she say?
Enough is enough, right? No, she basically said she just loved the balance of the red wine vinegar and the heat at the end. It's just bright, flavorful, fresh. I mean, she was blown away, so... It meant a lot for me.
All right. Well, let's show everybody.
Let's show how to make this right now.
But first, let's start with the lamb chops.
Lamb chops. We got these beautiful rib lamb chops.
Did you hear your baby? You want lamb chops?
Hi, baby. We got these beautiful rib lamb chops that we started off. I just put a little salt and pepper and a little olive oil.
Okay.
And, you know, of course, you can do this with leg of lamb. You could do this with loin chops. I mean, whatever, but I like the ribs, like little lollipops.
Yeah, right? I love it.
I like to cook it a couple of minutes on each side. You want it about 140 to 145. Which is medium rare.
Perfect.
Do not eat well done, or else just eat chicken then.
Yeah.
No, you're right.
Forget about it.
Or just eat this piece of wood.
Just eat the piece of wood, right?
Okay, so now to your famous chimichurri.
Yes. So.
Are you going to tell us everything that's in it?
No.
You're giving up your special sauce?
I'm just going to give up one. No, I'm not going to tell everything.
Okay.
I can't. So we got some onions.
Okay.
All right.
There we go.
We got some garlic. You need the garlic in there.
That's a lot of garlic.
You need that garlic. You got to pick it up. Italian parsley, which I love, the flat parsley, flat leaf parsley. Don't use curly parsley because there's no flavor. It's just for garnish.
Okay.
And, of course, mint is the star here because we are doing a mint chimichurri, of course.
But you could do chimichurri with other things as well, correct?
Yeah. My original recipe that I did for Gail Simmons, we had oregano and cilantro. And that's so really flavorful and light. And you could put that over grilled meat. Fish, chicken, you could do it as a dipping sauce for bread.
It's so good.
And I've done for a tofu. If you're vegetarian,
tofu,
put it right on top. I mean, it's pretty cool.
That was me.
Red wine vinegar is the key. Some people do lemon juice. I love the red wine vinegar. And then olive oil.
Some beautiful olive oil.
Oh.
Red pepper flakes,
and then red pepper chili flakes. You got to kick it up a notch. You need that pop at the end, that little heat. A little salt.
And pepper.
More pepper.
Beautiful.
There you go. And then I'm going to let you do this.
Okay, now, but I don't want to mess it up.
No.
Because I know
you
there's
You can
a...
mess this up.
Yes.
We do not want a pesto here.
Okay? Oh.
Because I've seen people just ruin this thing. So we just, a couple of pulses just like this. Because you want it to have a consistency. Slowly. Treat it like a baby.
Like a baby. Gentle.
Wait, you put your baby in a blender?
No, you don't put the baby in a blender. You would go there.
Do not do that.
Do not do that, Mark. See, that's simple.
So you want it more like a salsa than you
Kind of like a salsa, yeah. Okay. A vinaigrette. Can you say it again?
Vinaigrette. You want it like a vinaigrette.
That's it.
There we go. And that's it.
It's pretty.
Look at that. It's beautiful.
And it's still chunky.
Oh, that's nice.
You know? And
you could do it maybe a little more, but I like it like that.
Yeah.
Well, I'm playing sous chef today.
She's playing sous chef.
All right. Now, we're going to serve this beautiful chimichurri over our lamb chop with your cauliflower mash.
I really love it.
This is amazing.
I love the cauliflower mash because it's a great way to get the kids to eat their vegetables, of course. So, and it tastes like mashed potatoes.
It does. And you can't tell
it's
the difference.
It's amazing.
No,
what do you
not
do
at
with
all.
The, how do you do your cauliflower mash?
I just basically boil cauliflower and then puree it in the food processor. A little butter, a little half and half. You want to kick up
half
a notch.
And half.
A little white truffle oil.
Beautiful. Do you do Parmesan in it at all?
That's
garlic.
Garlic. No, your stuff, baby.
All right, I do that for Thanksgiving every year.
Oh, it's so
good. We're going to plate this up.
Look at
that. Oh, that's beautiful.
All righty.
Oh, my goodness, Marcel.
Now, while you're doing that, we have something in common. You probably don't know this, other than the rose. George Clooney.
What?
You,
good old Georgie.
You have cooked for him, personally cooked for him.
Yes.
I, too, have seen his movies. So we're, like, related almost.
You are related.
Right?
Wow. We are related.
Oh, yeah.
No, what's George like? What is he like?
You know,
what's
I mean, like? Come on. Who does not love George Clooney?
Everybody.
He's charming.
Him.
He's good looking. Just like I'm marketing.
Yeah.
Come on, you guys.
Anytime.
You know what I mean? But he's a guy's guy. He's really humble.
Really
yeah.
You know what I mean?
And he's a family man.
He's a family man. He's got kids now. And, you know, it's like who gets a chance to cook with a pet pig?
Yeah.
Oh. You're not calling George a pig.
No, Max. It's a pig.
Like, what are you talking about here?
Pigs.
So he has a pet pig.
Well, rest in peace, you know.
Yeah, he's gone.
Oh.
Yeah.
But, you
know,
he,
what happened? When you show up and the pig is gone, Marcel.
Can I ask you what you ate when the pig was there?
Yeah. We did not eat bacon.
Okay.
I had instructions. Do not make bacon.
Lamb chops.
I said, yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
Sushi.
Well, I made him an ahi tuna tartar, which he loved. But, you know, I've cooked with so many people. He's a regular guy, you know.
Isn't he?
He's just a normal guy like all of us, except for making $30 million a picture. But
other than
that, it's okay.
All right. Again, well, Marcel.
A lot. Yeah.
Next time you come, we'd love for you to bring George by. No big deal.
You know what? Let me call him right now.
We're also normal people.
I can,
we're totally normal.
I can get
people.
To him. I can get to him.
Okay. You have his personal
Blockbuster.
Line.
You've got a Blockbuster. You can get him there.
Blockbuster? What year is this?
He's on Netflix too now.
He's on Netflix.
So I'm going to finish this off. Lamb chops, right?
So crazy, Marcel.
We're going to add the chimichurri right on top because there's all that love right here.
Beautiful.
And, you know, it's important. My biggest saying, you eat with your eyes. It's got to look good. So
it's beautiful. Should we just?
It's delicious.
Do we? Okay,
by the way,
you've got to dig
that
in
was,
as well.
It was here so
you go.
Tender.
Just pick it up.
You're right on. It was so
there
tender.
You go.
Anything
oh
else
gosh,
is so chicken.
I say you just pick it up with your hand. Just
munch
on. Munch on. Come on. Come on.
We're so used to seeing Debbie do this at lunch every day. Come on.
Medium rare. Perfect.
Full recipe is available by dropping by HallmarkChannel.com and connect with Marcel. He's got a website. Information is there on the bottom of your screen. We're going to come right back, and Ken is going to take a turn.
Yes, George Clooney will not be there, but I will be. And we're making wonderful wooden bead snowflakes.
Do they have a Mont Blanc?